Hello, my brothers. Hello, my sisters. Another beautiful, blessed day today to always be in the presence of the Lord. Another day just to give him the thanks right now. Another day just to give him the worship, the praise right now. Another day just to lift your voice up and give him the glory right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And if you know that Jesus has been so good to you today, and if you know that he is so awesome to you right now today, won't you please open up your mouth right now today and give him some praise. Give him some glory. Magnify and shout out his holy name right now today. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you today, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. We praise and we honor your name. We glorify your name today, Jesus. We just want to say thank you today. 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 We just want to say thank you today, Jesus. We just want to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. In Jesus' name. That's what I mean, my brothers, my sisters. Give Jesus some praise. He deserves it all. Praise is an everyday thing. It's not an on and off switch thing. It's not a seasonal thing. It is an everyday thing because our Heavenly Father God, he is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. He never changes like the weather. And he never changes like us, and he never changes his mind. He's still sitting on the throne. He's still performing miracles and wonders each and every day. So just don't praise him when things are going good, but you want to praise him for who he is and what he has done. You want to praise him when things not going good. You want to praise him when things are difficult. You want to praise him during the dark time. You want to praise him in the storm. You want to praise him in the wilderness. Praise should always be on the fruit of your lips. Praise should always be in your heart. Praise should always be in your spirit. Give him the praise right now in Jesus' holy mighty name. Glory! Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And it's such a blessing today to have all my brothers and all my sisters today to be part of today's service today. And once you take your time out to be part of Jesus' service, automatically your day go well, the rest of the week go well, because why? You have put Jesus first. You could have been doing anything else, but you chose to put Jesus first. And when you put Jesus first place, then when Jesus is able to do things in your life, that he's able to give you things to do in your life. And I just want to let you know how thankful, how grateful, how honored and blessed I am right now today. So if I'm thankful and I'm honored and I'm blessed, how much more do you think our Heavenly Father God is? Right now, he is so thankful, honored, and blessed because of your guys' faithfulness and your obedience that you have towards this ministry. Right now, that he is doing something new in your life. According to the word of God of Isaiah chapter 43, verses 18 through 20, that God has said he is doing something new. He is doing a new thing in your life. He said, do you perceive it right now? Perceive it? Are you aware of it? Do you notice? Do you have a count of the new things about to come your way? And if you believe and not doubt, but knowing your heart and knowing your spirit that God is about to do some new things in your life, I want you to give some praise right now and say, something new is coming to my life this year, this season, in 2019. And I believe and I declare it right now today. I'm speaking over every dry bone right now today. I'm speaking into an existence right now today. And I'm prophesizing over it right now today that you're about to receive some new things this year, this season, in 2019. Amen. Amen. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. And he is worthy, and he is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah! We thank you today, Jesus. Amen. Amen. My brothers, my sisters, is there anyone out there in the world today that is ready to give their life to Christ right now today? I boldly encourage you right now today to please step out on faith and please head to the altar right now today. Is there anyone out there in the world today who's been going through some things, far suffering, depression? You've been going through a lot of anxiety. You've been going through a lot of setbacks. You've been feeling emotional drained right now, and that you are tired of going through this and you don't know what to do. The best thing for you to do right now today, if you're going through any kind of those symptoms right now today, you need to step out on faith right now today and head to the altar right now today and leave whatever it is that's bothering you. Leave whatever it is that's hindering you, that's keeping you up all time of the night, that's keeping you from tossing and turning, that's keeping you from not thinking right, what's keeping you and taking you off course and focus. You need to leave it at your altar right now today, because according to the word of God, In 1 Peter chapter 5, Jesus said he cares for you. He cares for that pain. He cares for that depression. He cares for that suffering. He cares for them setbacks. He cares whatever it is that's bothering you right now today. Leave it at the altar. Jesus said, take it and give it to me. I will take care of that problem for you. Amen? Amen. Is there anyone out there in the world today that want to be used by God right now today? I boldly encourage you right now today to please step out on faith and head to the altar right now today. Is there anyone out there in the world today that's been looking for a church home? You've been looking, but yet you haven't found anything yet. But it's something that's telling you about Jesus' ministry right here. It's something telling that you want to be part of this ministry right now today. And if you want to be part of Jesus' ministry, all you have to do is hit that red subscribe button. It's not my button. It's his button. It's not my ministry. It's his ministry. He just lent it to me. And I guarantee you, my brothers, my sisters, we're going to have some praise together. We're going to have some worship together. We're going to do everything together because we are brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus. That's what we're here for. If you want, we're going to pray. We're going to pray together. We're going to laugh together. We're going to cry together. We're going to do everything because you are my brother. I'm your brother. You are my sister. We're going to be family. And that's what we're going to be because that's what we are, family in Christ Jesus. Amen? Amen. And my point is why I'm always talking about this, because every day somewhere around the world, one of God's kids procrastinating in life. You always say you're going to do this. You always say you're going to do that. But you never, never make time for God. You always making excuses. You'll do anything else. But when God asks you to do something and God tells you to do something, you always put it on the back burner. You always make a room to put it on the top shelf. And right now, a lot of people have done it right now today. But someone right now today is fighting for their life right now today in the hospital. But we are praying for them right now today for a speedy recovery so they can come home. There's a lot of people right now who don't have that chance, who don't have that opportunity anymore because they're dead and gone. My point is, my brothers and my sisters, the Word of God tells us that tomorrow is not promised to neither one of us. Not next week, not next month, or next year. And if you have not asked Jesus to come into your life to be your Lord and Savior Christ, today is the day that you need to open your mouth. Today is the day that you need to declare this right now today. I don't know who I'm talking to right now today, but there's somebody right now today have not made a confession right now today. And all you got to say is, today is the day, Lord Jesus, that I boldly ask of you to come into my life to be my Lord and Savior Christ. And once you boldly confess that, right then and there you're saved, you are born again, you have just accepted and received the Holy Spirit. And I believe somewhere around the world, someone just got saved. I believe right now today that the angels are rejoicing and praising because someone just made that bold confession. At one point in my life, my brothers, my sisters, I was lost just like y'all until I made that bold confession. You got to open up your mouth. You got to declare. You got to speak it right now today. There's too many people right now today don't have a chance. There's too many people right now that's fighting for their life in the hospital because they have not made that confession. Do not wait till it's too late, because when it's too late, it's too late. Nobody knows the time, nobody knows the date, and nobody knows the hour. When something's going to happen or it's time for you to go home. Do not worry about who's looking at you. Do not worry about what people might think or say about you, how they feeling about you. Because when God comes, because he will come, first thing he's going to say is, why did you make that confession? You had plenty of chances. You had plenty of opportunity. Even Minister LT was asking you. And if you need help making that confession, all you do is say so. We'll do it together, my brothers. We'll do it together, my sisters. There's a lot of lost people right now today. Why you think Jesus preached so much outside the temple? Because they were the lost souls was. There's a lot of lost people right now today who go to church with you every Wednesday, every Sunday, because they have not made that bold confession and they don't know anything about Christ Jesus. Amen? Amen. Open up your mouth today and confess it. Amen? Amen. My brothers, my sisters, I tell you what, we better have some church today. We about to have some church today, and this message that's going to hit somebody hard today. It's going to hit somebody the spirit today. It's going to hit somebody right in the gut today, because you know that your mind is not made up. You're still playing games. You're still thinking that you're young, but you're calling yourself a grown man, and you're calling yourself a grown woman. A grown man and grown woman got their mind together. They got their act together. They know what they want to do, and they're doing it. You can't be call yourself a grown man and a grown woman if your mind ain't made up. And right now, some of you right now, your mind is not made up. And how I know that? Because the Holy Spirit spoke to me early this morning. Early this morning, at the crack of dawn, while it was still dark outside. He said, El Chai, I need you to speak this word. Because a lot of my kids right now today, their mind is not made up. And they don't, if they only know they can do all things through Christ. Jesus not say some things, not a little bit of thing. He said they can do all things, no matter what it is. But he said a lot of my children right now, they are limiting themselves. They still playing. They still let people talk them down, talk them out of something when they can do it. I don't know what they're scared of. They can't like fear hold them back or hold them down when I'm telling them they can do all things. I would never say it if I didn't mean it. And Jesus say right now today, a lot of y'all guys right now today, your mind is not made up. But today somebody gonna take this word, somebody gonna receive this message today, gonna say, you know what? Enough is enough. I gotta get my mind made up and I'm gonna do it. I believe somebody gonna do it today. Amen. Amen. And before I get started, I always like to take the time out to give our Heavenly Father God all the thanks, all the praise, and all the glory. Oh, Heavenly Father God, I just can't thank you enough for this awesome and beautiful blessed day today. I can't thank you for this word today. I can't thank you for this message today. I just can't thank you enough for your grace and your mercy today. I just can't thank you for the elder we was able to bring today. I just can't thank you for the Holy Spirit, how it's moved to all my brothers, all my sisters, and all through your ministry today. I just can't thank you for your warm comfort right now today, God. I just can't thank you for your presence, how surrounded all my brothers and all my sisters around the world today. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. I just can't thank you for our health today. I can't thank you for our strength today. I can't thank you for our food that you have blessed and prepared our table with today. The clothing shoe that you put on that back. I just can't thank you know how you're moving mouths on our behalf right now today. I can't thank you how you're providing. I just can't thank you how you guiding us and you directing us to the light, Father God. I just can't thank you enough for everything that you have done and everything that you are doing. I just can't thank you for your faithfulness. I just can't thank you for your love. I just can't thank you for our blessing. I can't thank you for our breakthrough. I can't thank you for our anointing. I can't thank you for our deliverance. I can't thank you for our double portion. I can't thank you for our abundance of rain. I just can't thank you for your glory. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. 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 I just can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I put my faith, my trust, and my hope in you every day, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. I just 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 can't thank you enough for my brothers today. I just can't thank you enough for my sisters today. I just can't thank you for your ministry today. I can't thank you for your word today. I can't thank you for your message today. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. I just can't thank you enough. Amen. Amen. I just can't thank you enough. I just can't thank you enough. My brothers, my sisters, before we get into this word, I just want to preach to y'all real quick. It's time for y'all right now today, my brothers. It's time for y'all right now today, my sisters. And you know exactly who you are. Because I was at that one point in my life. It's time for y'all to make y'all mind up. It's time for you to make your mind up and do what God has called you to do. It's time for you to make your mind up and do what God has chosen you to do. It's time for you to make your mind up because God has endowed a gift in every last one of his children. A gift that you knew how to pray for. A gift that you knew how to work for. A gift that he gave you, a personal gift that nobody, I mean absolutely nobody, can take away from you. And some of you right now today, you're letting that gift just go by. Because if your mind ain't right, your heart ain't right. If your mind ain't made up, your heart ain't made up. Because some of y'all still want to play games. Some of you still playing games. Some of y'all still just let time just go by each and every single day. But you want to call yourself a grown man. But you want to call yourself a grown woman. You want to say that you got it going on. No, you do not. No, you do not. Because if you had it going on, your mind would be right. If you had it going on like you said that you had it going on, your spirit would be right. If you had it going on like you say you had it going on, your heart would be right. You'd be doing what God has called you to do. You would be doing what God has chosen to do. And a lot of you right now today, you're not doing that whatsoever. You're limiting yourself. You are so focused on worrying about what people might think or say about you. You should be your number one fan. You should be your number one cheerleader. Nobody can talk you out of anything unless you allow them to do it. But how they can talk you out of something if you give them the power to do it? It's you who giving people the power to talk you out of something that God has called and told you to do. Why are you so worried about them? Because they're not doing it? Because they're not focused? Because their mind ain't made up? That's why you're not doing it? Or they say it's never going to work. Some of you right now today, the reason why your mind ain't made up, because you're afraid what people might think or say about you. You are so afraid to step out on faith, and faith is not going to hurt you. Faith is not going to harm you. Faith is not going to turn you down. Faith is not going to talk back to you. Faith is not going to curse you out. Faith is something that you believe in without even knowing or seeing it. And right now today, some of you right now, you are limiting your own faith. The word of God says in Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5, says he knew you when you was in your mother's womb. He knew everything about you. He knew you was going to be a man. He knew that you was going to be a woman. He knew the mistakes that you was going to make. He knew when he was going to get back. He knew that when he was going to get right back on course. So he already knew that. It was already mapped out. Your mother didn't know that. Your father didn't know that. Your so-called friends didn't know that. Or your family members didn't know that. But Jesus, your heavenly Father God, the creator of the heaven and the universe, he knew that. And the reason why I know he knew that, because we go down to Jeremiah 29:11 and say, I have a plan for you. A plan that will not hurt you, that not will harm you. Right then and there, he said, I got a perfect plan. A plan that he designed for you. A plan that can never expire, my brothers. A plan can never be outdated, my sisters. He designed that plan for you and only you. That plan has your name on it. And right now, your mind is not made up because you are not seeking that plan. You're not doing anything in that plan. So how can you say that you're a grown man, a grown woman, when it's already laid down for you? He already don't lay down the groundwork. All you got to do is trust it. All you got to do is step out in faith. All you got to do is believe and say, you know what? I'm going to make my mind up and I'm going to do it. I'm not worried about what people might think or say about me. I'm not worried about the haters. I'm not worried about the naysayers. I'm not worried about focusing on how they feel about me or what they say I can't do. I know I can do it. So what you waiting on today? Some of you right now today, you really don't believe in God like you say that you do. Because if you believe in him the way that you say that you believe in him, and if you trust in him the way that you trust in him, he said that you can do all things. Not some, not a little bit. He said that you can do all things through Christ that give you strength. How do you get your strength? You get your strength by seeking him. You get your strength by praising him. You get your strength by worshiping him. So when you do that, he's providing on the back end to give you what you need to do in your assignment, what you need to do in your mission, what you need to do, what you are called and chose to do. But first of all, you got to make up your mind. First of all, you got to say enough is enough. You got to say, you know what, I cannot do this no more. At one point in my life, my brothers, my sisters, I was just like y'all. It took some time for me to get there, but when I got there, I said, you know what, enough is enough. At one point in time, my brothers and my sisters, let me just preach to you real quick before I get into this word. I was real good and talented in sports. Real good and talented. But every time when I had a game, I wanted my parents to be at the game. My mom, she couldn't be there because she was so focused and busy in the hospital, you know, trying to get us out of the project. So she was always working, just going to school to try to get a better life for us. My father, he was there, but he always hung out with his friends. You know, I knew I was good, but I stopped going because I didn't believe in myself the way I did. I knew I was good because I was depending on them just to be there so I could say, you know what, I know I can do it. So what I do, I limit myself. I walked away from it. So as my dad passed away in 1994, I said, okay, I'm going to try it again. But what I do, I limit myself again. So what I do again, I let my dad down. I let myself down, and I let God down. So as my mom passed away in 2004, automatically I made my mind up right then and there. I said, God, I don't let you down so many times. I don't disappoint you so many times. I say, Dad, I have let you down so many times. I have disappointed you so many times. I say, Ma, I say, I have let you down so many times. I have disappointed you so many times. I say, but enough is enough of that. I say, right now today, I'm putting my big boy pants on. I'm putting my big boy underwear on. I say, I had enough is enough. I say, I'm making my mind up. I say, I made a vow to God first. I made a vow to my parents that I will never disappoint them. I will never let them down. I will never leave them hanging, because at the end of the day, God never disappointed me. He never let me down. My mom or my dad never disappointed me. They never let me down. So at that point right there in 2004, my mind was made up. I became a man. I said, enough is enough. I'm not going to limit myself. I don't care what people might think about me. I don't care how they say about me. I don't care how they feel about me. I don't care about the haters. I don't care what the naysayers say. I'm going to do it because the word of God says I can do it. And I'm going to tell you why the word of God says you can do it. Please turn your Bibles to Philippians 4. And we're going to read verse 13. Philippians 4, verse 13. It says, I can do everything through him who gives me strength. Now look how Jesus broke that down. He said, I, who was I? He talking about you, my brothers. He talking about you, my sisters. He said, I can do everything through who? Through him. It's Jesus who lives through us, who gives you what? Who gives you the strength. And where your strength come from? By seeking him, praising him, and worshiping him. He said you can do it all. So tell yourself what it is today that you want to do. Tell yourself what it is today that you want to be. Tell yourself what it is today. You say, you know what? I know I can do it, because Jesus' word said I can do everything. He didn't say some things. He didn't say a little bit thing. He said you can do everything what you set your mind to. But the first step that you got to do is make your mind up. Your mind got to be set, because everything starts right there. Once this right here is set, the heart gonna get set. It can't be the heart and not the mind. It can't be the mind and not the heart. It got to be two out of two, my brothers, my sisters. Once your mind is set, your heart gonna be set. And all you got to do is step out on faith and say, you know what? I can do this. I'm not going to limit myself. I'm not going to worry about what people might think or say about me. I'm not going to worry about the haters. Yes, I know people are going to laugh at me. I know people are going to have their critics. I know people are going to have their opinions. But their critics and their opinions don't mean nothing to me. Because Jesus' words say, I can do everything. And that's what I'm going on. Everything. Because I am everything. Because I can do everything. Because it is Jesus who lives in me. If Jesus said I can do it, I can do it. That's what I believe in. That's what I trust in. That's my whole point, my brothers, my sisters. When Jesus said that you can do it, automatic, the rest is history. You ain't got to worry about what nobody think or say about you. He said that you can do everything. But you got to get your mind right first so you can do everything. Amen? Amen. I see so many people right now, you just walk out and you leave your dreams. You're not doing what God has called you and chose you to do because you're so focused on what people might think or say. Because they want to fail at life, don't mean that you don't have to fail. Because they don't want anything in life, don't mean that you shouldn't want anything out of life. You should want something out of life. You should want to do better, because look at yourself in the mirror. Every day and say, you know what? I can do it. I'm looking at my family. I don't see nobody in my family stepping up, but I'm going to be the first one in my family to step up. I don't see all the people I used to hang with. They're not doing it with their life, but I'm going to do something in my life. I can do it. I don't care what nobody think. I don't care what nobody say. I don't care what nobody feel. I can do it, because Jesus' word said I can do everything. And when Jesus said that you can do everything, the rest is history. So if you really believe in Jesus, like you say you believe in him, and if you really trust in him, and if you really have faith and hope in him, like you say that you can do, what's the problem? It shouldn't be no problem, point blank. It should be no problem whatsoever when the word of God said that you can do everything. So what's your problem today, my brothers? What is your problem today, my sisters? My point is, get your mind right and do it. Quit letting that time go by. Quit wasting time. Quit looking around to see what somebody might think or say and make their move today. He said you can do it. He said you can do everything. The only person who can stop you is you. And right now, some of you right now today, you are stopping yourself because you're too focused on what everybody might think or say about you. Block them out of your head. But who is they to tell you that you can't do it when Jesus said that you can do everything? Who is they to tell you that's never going to happen when Jesus said you can do everything? Who is they to say you're wasting your time when the word of God said that you can do everything? Who is they? They should be nobody to you. But when Jesus said that you can do everything, it is him who give you strength. And how you get your strength? Seeking him, praising him, worshiping him, and putting him first place. As long as you're doing it, he's providing on the other end. Jeremiah 1 through 5, what it says, he knew you was in the womb. He knew everything about you. Jeremiah 29:11 says he have a perfect plan. That plan's already been laid down. That plan's already been a foundation. Philippians 4:13 said that you can do everything. Who is I? He said you, my brothers. He talking about you. You are the I. Can do it. You can do it. So my point is today, my brothers, my sisters, make your mind up and do it. Don't limit yourself. Don't even question it. He said today is the day. My mind is made up. I had enough of enough. No longer I'm going to continue to doubt myself. No longer I'm going to continue to waste time. No longer I'm going to continue to let people talk me down or talk me out of something when Jesus already told me I can do everything. That should be your motivation right now. This is a motivation ministry speech right now today. You should tell yourself right now today, you know exactly who you are. Enough is enough. I can do it. Once you get your mind made up, your heart is already made up too. So the point is in this message, make your mind up today and do it, because you can do everything, because Jesus said that you can do everything. Amen. Amen. So I hope that this word, I hope that this message is going to help somebody today, because I believe today somebody's going to say enough is enough. They're going to do it today. They're going to step out on faith. They're going to trust God. Whatever it is. And if you don't know what God has called you to do or chosen to do, spend some time with him. And once you spend time with him, he's going to reveal to you exactly the plan that he already had laid out. And once he revealed the plan, say, you know what? I can do it because.